All started, good to go. All right, in front of the door. All right. Shoulders back, heads up, smile. 3, 2, 1, go.
Come in.
Hello, Robert.
Yes.
How you doing today? Brendan Deegan from 7
Hey, brother.
Insurance.
Good to see you.
Nice to meet you. It's a pleasure to meet you. You mind if I take a seat before?
No, come on.
Awesome. Your secretary told me you have a very little time to share. I hear you got 15 minutes, so I'm just going to leave this right here. So I don't take too much of your time.
Okay.
So I was actually very excited to find out that I was meeting with a golf manager today because I've been playing golf my entire life. Do you play golf yourself?
I do.
Yeah,
I do.
What are you shooting a handicap at?
Well, we don't want to talk about
yeah,
that.
Exactly.
We don't want to talk
lower,
about that.
Lower,
you
lower,
know.
Lower. I forgot to
I work too much.
Exactly.
See, that's the,
exactly.
That right
exactly.
There?
Here's my business card.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, so I don't want to take up too much of your time. I heard you guys were looking for new insurance policy because the renewal date's coming up. So I just wanted to talk about your current plan, what you like about it, what you don't like about it, your future plans for the course, and how Seminole Insurance can come in and help you out
and
find a package that fits for you guys. Does that sound okay to you?
It does. It does.
Perfect. Okay. So is there anyone else that should be at this meeting or anyone else deciding?
Not at this meeting.
Okay.
But there is a committee.
Okay.
I chair the committee. There's two other board members that are on the committee.
Two. And what are their names?
Bill Jones,
okay.
And Jason Wright.
Okay, Jason Wright, perfect.
And then we're seeing if there's a fit here.
Awesome.
And then of course then the next meeting, if there
perfect.
Is a next meeting,
absolutely.
We'll have the full committee together.
Now I know your plan renews on June 1st, I believe.
July 1st.
July 1st.
Yep.
So when will you try to get?
I want
to
put this to bed by June 1st.
June 1st.
So you had that date right.
Yeah.
It's just the renewals July 1st.
June 1st, a month in advance.
Yep.
Perfect.
Yep.
All right. So I want to just get a little conscious about your club and see what kind of things
you
have. So tell me a little bit about it. Do you have any restaurants on the course?
We do.
Okay.
You know, we have a pro shop.
Okay.
We have a restaurant. We serve alcohol. We have a nice wine selection.
Yeah. How many bars do you have?
Just one.
Just one bar?
One. Oh, yeah.
All right, perfect. And how long has your course been around? I know you're fairly new to the...
You know, I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah.
But would you say pretty old?
Oh, yeah. It's a
well-established
club here in Tallahassee.
So pretty old. Okay. And I just wanted to say my condolences about your old course. I mean, I can only imagine how tragic that is.
It's still sad.
My roommate actually lived out in Panama City, and his house was completely torn down. He had to come live with me back up in New York over that time being. But, yeah, it was hard on everyone.
Mm.
I can only imagine. But, yeah. So how many holes do you have on your golf course?
It's an 18-hole
18-hole?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. And you have valet parking. You offer valet parking for your members.
No, everybody. Everybody's on their own on that.
Awesome. Yeah. Okay. And how many employees would you say?
We have about 50.
50. Okay. And how many of those are full time, part time?
They're all full time.
Awesome.
Yeah, we've got a good, well established staff.
All right. Awesome. And how many? Talk to me about membership. How many members you got? What are the
fees? Right around 1,000.
1,000.
You know.
Members?
That's probably the membership role, but it's like any organization,
yeah,
how many are at.
Exactly. So what's the membership process? Is there fees, an entry fee or monthly fees?
Yeah, there's a buy-in fee of $2,500.
$2,500, okay.
And depending on whether you become a social member or a golf
coming
club
up,
member,
yeah,
it could be a couple $100 a month.
You have a conference center for like receptions or events or some things like
you
that?
You know, that's something we've talked about.
Okay,
we don't currently have it, but certainly one of the goals that I've been tasked with is to expand membership and to upgrade facilities, to start doing some things to grow membership.
So you want to have future renovations and absolutely you want to make sure you're covered on all that. And
correct.
So there's no mishaps with that. So
have
you had the property appraised? I know we're probably going to come in and appraise it ourselves, but what would you say the property value is at before we get in there and we start taking
I think that? All in, we're probably looking at about
$5
million
in
total insured value.
Perfect. And then how much do you guys bring in from the restaurant, from the bars, from membership fees, obviously? What would you say your net income or sales would be per year?
I think at this point it's probably $100,000 a month.
Awesome. So you guys are doing pretty well for yourselves. And how many, so you said you don't have a reception area right now, but how many, opens and tournaments do you guys have throughout the years?
Well, we don't currently have any.
Okay.
We want to put one together.
Yeah, I heard a little
about 2020.
Mm-hmm. I heard he's working with Tiger Woods, correct?
Correct.
Yeah, I actually met Tiger Woods. I was a security guard at the U.S. Open up in Shinnecock Hills last year. So I was working right outside the player locker room. I met Phil Mickelson, Tiger Woods. It was like,
wow, man, look at you.
Exactly. I thought it was just a free ticket to the US Open. So I certified, went in, met everyone. I wish I was able to take pictures though, but you have to be professional and things like that. And I actually did work on a golf course back in high school.
Okay.
So I understand the day-to-day.
Good. So you've got to understand.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so let's go into some of your current plan and tell me a little bit about it, what you like, where you think you want to get more coverage in the future with. Tell me a little bit about it.
Well, the concern is, you know, if we're on this growth trajectory, we want to make sure as we upgrade the facilities, as we expand some of the offerings that we have, especially the golf tournament, expand into other things, to potentially add an executive course for our more seasoned golfers.
Absolutely.
And then certainly to attract members, we thought we would create some family space, some place for the kids to play, some areas for families to real feel comfortable. That, you know, weren't into golf,
absolutely,
but wanted to be a member of a country club.
Mm-hmm. So you're planning on growing and renovating and bringing in more members, which is awesome.
Correct.
For
correct.
An upcoming golf course. So you want growth. And how, what would you say, what are some of the claims you filed since you've been with the golf course? I want to just kind of get a...
Well, my understanding, even though I was at the previous club, which was devastated, there's some damage here at this club that we've been experiencing. We had some trees down. We have some damage to some of the facilities. And so we were down in this club, believe it or not, about 30 days.
Yeah. Okay. Wow.
And we're still dealing with some of that. And that's part of the concern that the committee has and the board has. We thought we'd be a lot farther along in that claim process.
Absolutely.
You know, since the loss happened back in October.
Absolutely, yeah. So you're worried about storm damage, even though it is somewhat inland, but you can never be too cautious down here in Florida.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And what's your current deductible running you, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, we actually currently have a 5% wind and hail deductible.
Okay.
So it's pretty expensive for that.
So that's an area of concern you want to kind of look at?
Yeah, I mean, that's a lot of money, and certainly the members are concerned because they have to write the check.
Yeah, absolutely.
And pay for it.
And now how much time are you personally spending looking and finding new quotes for the new coverage?
Well, this is my primary task right now, other than running the club, because we want to definitely go with somebody that certainly feels that's can help us grow.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And help us make sure that when we call, you're there for us.
Absolutely.
Make sure as we expand into other areas that you can expand with us.
Absolutely. So you're worried about having an agent that wants to be there throughout the entire process and there every step of the way.
There's no doubt about
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. So, I mean, some people see me as a new agent with the company and they think I'm a young guy, but I see myself as a hungry go-getter. I want to be out there. I want to be getting as much experience as possible. And your situation is very similar to one of the other clients I have. I actually have a recommendation letter that talks about that you can call them and they can attest to my hard work and demeanor to that. But, you know, they had a flood in the restaurant in the middle of the night. And, you know, I was there with them, you know, bucketing out water, making sure that they got through this. And through that, we were able to get them back and running within 2 weeks, which is a turnaround time, which is incredible.
Wow, that's impressive.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's impressive.
But being me so young and I don't have as much of a client base as some of my older co-workers, it gives me the opportunity to invest as much time and making sure my customers are completely satisfied with whatever their problem is. And, you know, I can't sit here and show you, you know, a brand new Mercedes when a ball goes in it through at the range or you know, give you a new course when the storm comes through. But what I can sit here and sell you a peace of mind and tell you that when stuff goes down and hits the fan, that I'll be there through every step of the way to make sure it gets fixed. And I want to be there through that process and make sure that everything is back to normal and even better than it was before the things happened. And that's what we bring at Sentinel
Insurance. Wow, okay.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, that's refreshing.
Yeah, absolutely. So do you have any questions for me moving forward?
Well, you've kind of addressed a couple of them, you know, because claims is a concern.
Yes.
And you said, you know, you're basically available 24/7.
Yeah, I do my best, exactly.
So, you know, and I understand when things happen.
Absolutely.
And then, you know, if we decide to make a change to go with Seminole, you know, what why would we do that? Why would we put our asset into your hands?
Well, what we do at Seminole is we are constantly updated with the new, just for example, building codes and things like that to make sure that your coverage is up to date and you're covered throughout everything. You know, we offer possibly an umbrella policy, things like that, so that when God forbid you aren't covered, you guys are still covered. You're not taking money out of your pocket. And we want to just make sure that you guys are covered through for whatever ideas or goals that you guys want to meet as a golf course. And we come in and we make sure we're there every step of the way and make sure you guys can fulfill your goals. And, you know, we're more of a family kind of in like family aspect of it. We're not going to be your business partners. We're going to be there with you. You know, I'd love to go out there and play a couple holes with you every once in a while, you know, hit
absolutely.
Exactly. You know, and build that kind of relationship. So I'm not trying to be your business partner. I'm trying to be your friend and I want to work through this and help you guys get things done that you want to do. Absolutely. So as we were going over this, I was looking at some of the possible insurance coverages that you're going to need for your package, and we're building some up. Obviously, general liability, and we can actually add like construction liability and things like that. So while you're doing construction, you're going to want to be covered for tournament prize insurance for this upcoming tournament that you need. You know, you don't want to be, you know, paying for that, you know, $50,000 BMW that somebody hits a hole in one, and God forbid. But you know, we can look into a business owner liability if you qualify for it. We can obviously go into umbrella policy because you understand the value of your course and how that can be taken away from you, like at a snap of a finger.
Yeah.
And we want to make sure that that's not going to happen again, what happened out in Panama and things like that. So we want to make sure this course is staying here. It's been around for a while. We want to make sure it's here,
right,
you know, for the next, as many times as we can. And it was Tiger Woods coming in. If he's going to be playing at that tournament and things like that, we want to make sure maybe we can make this a spot on the tour or something like that.
Wow, man. I like the thought of that. We got to
see what we can do.
You got big plans for us.
Absolutely. So I wanted to go over this more in depth. Obviously, this is just a broad description of everything. But I was wondering if maybe we can set up a further meeting to go over a package with one of my associates who can build a package for you. We can get you some quotes and we can find a flexible area where that satisfies all your needs. Would you be able?
I would be amenable to that.
Awesome.
Yeah, sure.
Are you available tomorrow night around 8:00? We can get some dinner. We can go over a presentation for you.
No, you know, that's family time.
Oh, absolutely. So what about maybe like lunch on next Wednesday?
Lunchtime's busy for us.
Okay.
So let's say one morning, 8:30-ish, I have to drop the kids off.
Yeah, perfect.
So
yeah, exactly. And I want to make sure that you get this problem out of your hands so you're not spending extra time with the course. I know it's a long day. You're there from morning to night.
Yeah, and I appreciate
exactly.
You saying that.
You need family time.
Absolutely. You know, finally got the kids and the wife here settled, and, mm-hmm. you know, we got to.
Exactly. I understand how it is. But, yeah, I mean, being on a golf course, I mean, our head pro is in there from morning to night, and he barely gets time to go home and see his family and things like that. But it's sunset to sunrise, and you know, if you wanted to add more things like that, we want to make sure you're covered.
Yeah.
You have the opportunity to go spend time with your family and obviously like that. So
well, I appreciate that.
Absolutely. Yeah. So I'm going to take this to my associate. We're going to build a package, and then we'll meet maybe Monday at 8:30 next week. Does that work for you?
Works fine.
Perfect.
All right.
Looking forward to speaking
Thank
with you.
You.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it.
Have a good one.
All right.
Thank you.